Indianapolis and the ride-sharing app Lyft have been providing rides to and from local grocery stores for just a dollar. CBS 4's Brett Cass joins us in our newsroom now to show us how the program has done to fight food insecurity. Brett.
Yeah, Debbie, since it began about 6 months ago, the Lyft Indy Grocery Access Program has given out more than 1,000 rides to roughly 130 people. Many are shopping for more than just themselves.
Today, I'm just probably going to grab some...
A quick trip to the grocery store.
Probably some lettuce and tomatoes for dinner.
Can be easier said than done.
If they have any lettuce.
Especially when you live on the Far East Side in one of Indy's many food deserts.
Living on this side of town is pretty scary, you know, when you don't have a grocery store you can have easy access to.
Don Jerica Walton and her four kids live on the Far East Side. She says the closest grocery store is a 10-minute drive and no bus route takes her there.
It's not walking distance or anything.
Walton is one of about 200,000 Indy residents said to be living in a food desert where affordable, healthy food can be hard to find.
Living in a food desert for many people creates an extremely tough barrier just to do simple things such as getting groceries or getting important items for your family.
So when Lyft in the city rolled out a new grocery access program this summer, Walton signed up. She's able to order a Lyft anytime to a nearby grocery store and pay just a dollar each way, while the drivers still get their usual cut, unaware that she's in the program.
That's why I like it, because I don't have to feel ashamed, you know, that I don't have enough money to pay for a ride to the grocery store.
Walton says she's able to spend more money on groceries thanks to the savings on getting here. She's hoping this program can continue until the food desert she lives in is no more.
Hopefully that they see that this is an issue and that it needs to be handled.
And the pilot program was set to end at the end of this month, but the city says they'll be expanding it at least through January. It is budgeted for about 500 people, and so far, as we've said, roughly 130 people have signed up. Now, if you can find more information and find out how you can take part, on our website, cbs4indy.com. Here in the newsroom, I'm Brett Cast, CBS 4 News.
Brett, thank you. Well,